think the universe is trying to tell me something.
What would that be?
No need to grab a cup of coffee alone when you could be catching up with a friend. Do you want to sit down?
Sure.
Can we get another cup of coffee?
You really think cosmic forces are at work here?
Well, why else would we end up at Kelly's at the same time?
It's close to where both of us work, and you can't beat the price.
I think fate sounds better.
It does, but that depends on what fate has in store, doesn't it?
It's all good, trust me.
Really? You can see the future now? Wow. Thank you.
I just believe that when something bad happens to you, the universe rewards you something good happening. It's like the laws of physics.
I don't know about that.
Anyway, are you doing better? I hope that didn't come off as insensitive as it sounded.
No. I mean, some days are better than others. I don't really know why, but it looks like you caught me on a good day.
I never thought that I would have a good day after I lost my sister, but then one day Spinelli just did something completely ridiculous and I couldn't stop laughing. It's not that I didn't miss her anymore. It just felt good for somebody to pull me away from that pain. I kind of think you need that right now.
You think I should hang out with Spinelli?
No. Spinelli was good for me, but I don't think he's gonna take your mind off what's happening with Jake. What you need is family time. And I know technically you and Elizabeth aren't family anymore, but you're always gonna be the father to our kids.
Maxie. Hi.
Hey.
Looks like we all have the same idea.
Well, I guess it was fate. I mean, we were just talking about you, and here you are. I just came in for a quick cup of coffee. I'm gonna get going. You sit down.
No, I'm just gonna pick up some takeout, and then I'm leaving.
Well, now you have someone to wait with. It's like good karma in full effect. You and Lucky running into each other when you have so much to talk about.
We do?
Yeah. You know what they say. The path to healing begins with the truth.
I have to hand it to Maxie. Out of all the well-meaning words people have spoken, hers are the only ones that make me smile. Even though I have no idea what she's talking about half the time.
It's good to see you smile again.
How you holding up?
I have a lot of support from Gran and Steven. Even Maxie's trying to help in her own little weird way. You know, she's right. I think we need to talk. It's not good to keep all of this in.
Yeah. I've been putting this off for a little while, and now seems like as good a time as any, but we need to talk about Siobhan. Siobhan's visa extension got denied, so she has to leave the country.
And you don't want her to go?
Well, if she gets deported, she has to wait another year before she can reapply for another visa, and I know, I mean, it makes for a complicated situation. Green card marriage wouldn't really be any easier. I just don't see any other option.
Why were you putting off telling me?
It's not the best timing.
I didn't exactly take the news well the first time you told me. Lucky, I know if I'd let you take the boys to the wedding, Jake would still be here with us.
We have to stop doing that.
I could have made different choices.
You're not alone in that. But you can't help how you feel, Elizabeth. And I don't want you to hide either. I mean, if you have a problem with this or a concern, anything, I want you to tell me.
Are you asking my permission to marry someone else?
No, I just don't want to add to your pain.
The fact that you'd even consider my feelings after the way I've treated you, it means a lot to me.
Now, even though we're not together anymore, it doesn't mean that I don't care. I do. I'll always care.
It's kind of ironic that we'd be having this conversation here, in the place where we first met. I fell in love with you. Do you remember all those nights we used to dance at that old jukebox?
Yeah, eating ribs at Eli's, making brownies with Nicholas and Emily. Mm-hmm. Man, that seems like a long time ago, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, everything was so clear back then. I never imagined losing you. Or betraying you in any way.
And we both got lost at different times. You know, I'm the one that got the ball rolling with lies and deception with my addiction.
Well, the addiction, you had an excuse.
Oh, there's no excuse, Elizabeth. It was wrong on so many levels.
I don't want to talk about any of this. I'm just really sorry for all the pain that I've caused you. And if you want to marry Siobhan for whatever reason, then that's what you should do. I just want to see you happy.
Thank you.
Take it any longer. I want to know how Lucky took the news.
I couldn't tell him.
What do you mean you couldn't tell him? I set it up perfectly for you. All you had to do was say, Lucky, Aiden is your son. It was that easy. How could you not tell him?
Lucky wants to marry Siobhan.
What? Siobhan is the rebound girl. You don't marry the rebound girl.
She's being deported.
Oh, so now she's using him for a green card.
No, actually, it's more than that. He cares about her. And if I tell him that he's Aiden's father, then he won't go through with the wedding. And then she's gonna go back to Ireland, and he'll lose her because of me.
You're saying that like it's a bad thing. If Siobhan is out of the picture, then you get Lucky back and your family. Isn't that what you want?
When I slept with Nicholas, it really hurt Lucky. And he had a hard time getting over it. I don't want to get in the way of his happiness now.
Nothing would make Lucky happier than hearing he has another son.
But if I tell him the truth, he's gonna feel some sense of obligation to me, and I don't want to put him in that position. He deserves a chance to be happy with Siobhan.
Lucky doesn't even know Siobhan. Certainly not well enough to marry her. And I guarantee if you told him the truth, Lucky would have no problem saying goodbye to her, because what's most important to him is family.
Well, I'm not gonna use Aiden to hold on to Lucky. It's not fair.
What about this situation is fair to me?
Nicholas.
Hey, looks like I'm obviously interrupting.
Hey, got your message. What's wrong?
Okay, remember when you came here and you asked me to keep Jason from killing Luke?
Yeah?
Well, I don't think that's going to be possible anymore.
What happened?
Well, Luke came here looking for Jason, and he was really drunk.
Well, of course he was. He can't get through the day without a fifth of scotch in his system.
Yeah, well, thank God Jason wasn't here, because Luke was going off. Lucky, it would not have been pretty.
My dad's trying to goad Jason into killing him, isn't he?
He's not gonna have to try very hard.